Sixth question. Three consecutive integers add up to 51. What are these integers? Now, let us know the meaning of consecutive. Now, I will give some example. 1, 2, 3. These are called the consecutive example. Now, second example. 7, 8, 9. These are also called as consecutive number. Consecutive number means it should, if we add 1 to this number, it will become 2. If we add 1 to 2, then we will get 3. So the difference should be 1. Those type of numbers are called consecutive numbers. Now, let us take 3 consecutive numbers as x, x plus 1, x plus 2. We have taken 3 consecutive numbers as x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. Why? Because first number we have taken as x. If we add 1 to this, we will get x plus 1. If we add 1 to this, we will get x plus 2. Therefore, we have taken 3 consecutive numbers as x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. Now, they have given 3 consecutive integers add up to 51. If we add these 3 numbers, we will get as answer as 51. Now, we will add 3 number x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. If we add these 3 numbers, we will get as 51. Now, x, x, x. There are 3x, we will write it as 3x. Now, 1 plus 2, it will become 3. Now, first we will move plus 3 to the right side. 3x equal to 51 plus 3 will become minus 3. 3x equal to 51 minus 3 will be 48. X is equal to 48. Since the number 3 is multiplied, if we move to the right side, it will become divided by. Now, 3 1 ja 3, 16 ja. X is equal to 16. Now, the 3 consecutive numbers are 3 consecutive numbers are, we have taken it as x, x plus 1, x plus 2. We know the value of x is 16. Now 16. This will become 16 plus 1, which is equal to 17. This will become 16 plus 2, which will become 18. Therefore, the 3 consecutive numbers are 16, 17 and 18. 7th question. The sum of 3 consecutive multiple of 8 is 888. Find the multiples. Now, they have asked 3 consecutive multiple of 8. So, now let us take 3 consecutive multiple of 8 as x, x plus 8, x plus 16. So, I have taken 3 consecutive multiple as x, x plus 8, x plus 16. Because they have asked consecutive multiple of 8. Multiple of 8 means the difference should be 8. So, first I have taken as x, then I will add 8 to this. After that, I will add 8 to this, then I will get 16. Therefore, 3 consecutive numbers are x, x plus 8, x plus 16. Now, the sum of 3 consecutive multiple. If we add these three numbers, we will get the answer as 888. Now, x, 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 we will get it as 3x. Now, 8 plus 16 will be 24. 888. Now, first we will move the plus 24 to the right side. 3x is equal to 888 plus 24. If it go to the right side, it will become minus 24. 3x is equal to 8 minus 4 will be 4. 8 minus 2 will be 6. 8, 64. 3x equal to 8, 64. Now, we will find the x value. Since the number 3 is multiplied, If it go to the right side, it will become divided by. Now, 3 1 ja, 3 2 ja, 3 8 ja, and again 3 8 ja. X is equal to 288. Now, we have taken 3 consecutive multiple of 8, 3 consecutive multiple of 8 as, we have taken it as x, x plus 8, x plus 16. So, x value we know that 288. Now, 288 plus 8, it will become 296. Now, 288 plus 16, it will become 304. Therefore, the 3 consecutive multiple of 8 are 288, 296 and 304. Eighth question. 3 consecutive integers are such that when they are taken in increasing order and multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively, they add up to 74. Find this number. Now first, let us take 3 consecutive integers. Let us take 3 consecutive integers as x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. We know that consecutive integer means the difference should be 1. X, if you add 1 to this, we'll get as x plus 1. If you add 1 to this, we'll get it as x plus 2. Now, next line, are such that when they are taken in increasing order, these numbers are already in increasing order, and multiply by 2, 3 and 4 respectively. Multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively. So we should multiply the first number with 2, second number with 3 and third number with 4. Now let's multiply 2 into x, 2x, 3 into x plus 1, 4 into x plus 2, and they add up to 74. If we multiply and add these three numbers, we'll get the answer as 74. Now 2x, 3 into x will be 3x, 3 ones are 3, 4 into x is 4x, 4 twos are 8. Now 2x plus 3x will be 5x, 5x plus 4x will be 9x, 3 plus 8 will be 11, which is equal to 74. Now plus 11, if it moves to the right side, it will become minus 11. 74 minus 11 will be 63. X equal to 63. 9 number is multiplied. If it goes to the right side, it will become divided by 9 1 ja, 9 7 ja. X equal to 7. Now, 3 consecutive numbers are, we have taken it as x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. X, x plus 1, x plus 2. Value of x is 7. Now 7 plus 1 will be 8. X value is 7. 7 plus 2 will be 9. Therefore, the 3 consecutive numbers are 7, 8 and 9. Question number 9. The ages of Rahul and Arun are in the ratio 5:7. 4 years later, the sum of their ages will be 56 years. What are their present ages? Now, there are 2 persons, Rahul and Arun. Okay, now let Rahul's present age be, since they have given the ratio 5:7, Rahul will take it as 5x, be 5x. Then Arun's present age will automatically will be 7x. 5 is to 7 means if we take Rahul age as 5x, then Arun age will compulsory, you should take it as 7x. Okay? Now, 4 years later, 4 years later, 4 years later, Rahul age, 4 years Rahul age will be, present age was 5x, after 4 years, later means afterwards, so 4 years will be added. Arun age, his present age was 7x, after 4 years, even 7x plus 4. Arun age will also be 7x plus 4. Now, 4 years later, the sum of their ages, after 4 years, if we add both their ages, we'll get the answer as 56. Now, 5x plus 7x is 12x. 4 plus 4 will be 8, is equal to 56. Plus 8 will move to the right side. 12x is equal to 56 plus 8 will become minus 8. 56 minus 8 is 48. X is equal to 48. Since number 12 is multiplied, if it goes to the right side, it will become divided by. Now 12 ones are 12, 4s are. X is equal to 4. Now we'll write Rahul present age. We have taken Rahul present age as 5x. Is equal to 5 into x value is 4. 5 4s are 20 years. Rahul present age is 20 years. Now next, Arun present age. Arun present age, we have taken it as 7x. 7 into, here x value is 4. 7 4s are 28 years. Therefore, Arun present age will be 28 years. Rahul present age is 20 years and Arun present age is 28 years. 10th question. The number of boys and girls in a class are in the ratio 7 is to 5. The number of boys is 8 more than number of girls. What is the total class strength? They are asking the total class strength. Now, there are two categories, boys and girls. They have given in the ratio 7 is to 5. Now, let the number of boys be 7x. Since they have given the ratio 7 is to 5, boys will take it as 7x. Then girls will automatically will be 5x. Then number of girls will be 5x. If we take 7x, then girls will should take it as 5x. Now next we'll read the statement. The number of boys is means we'll write it as equal to 8. More means we'll write it as plus. More than the number of girls. Now, number of boys means 7x. 8 plus number of girls means 5x. Now, we'll first transfer plus 5x to the left side. Now, 7x plus x, if it comes to the left side, it will become minus 5x equal to 8. 7x minus 5x is 2x equal to 8. Now, x is equal to, since the number 2 is multiplied, if it goes to the right side, it will become divided by. Now, 2 1s are 2, 4s are. X is equal to 4. Now, number of boys. We have taken it as 7x. 7x. 7 into, here the value of x is 4. 7 4s are 28. Therefore, number of boys is equal to 28. Now, number of girls, we have taken it as 5x. 5 into, here the value of x is 4. 5 into 4 is equal to 20. Therefore, number of girls is equal to 20. But they have asked us total class strength. Now, total class strength. Total class strength means number of boys plus number of girls. Number of boys here is 28 plus number of girls is 20. 28 plus 20 will be 48. Therefore, total class strength will be 48.